بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين ثم الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. We give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making it possible for us to produce today's video on the subject at-tawheed, and inshallah will be with the sixth nullifier of al-Islam. The Shaykh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be merciful to him, he said that as sad is من استهزاء بشيء من دين الله أو ثوابه أو عقابه كفر والدليل قوله تعالى قل أبي الله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون لا تعتذروا قد كفرتم بعد إيمانكم. This is the sixth nullifier of an Islam, and which is on, that is, whosoever make fun or whosoever make jest of something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down to us, that is anything that is part of the of Islam, if I want to make fun of it, aw thawabihi, or something that deals with the reward. For example, if it has been said to us that if you are to fast on the day of Arafah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your past sin and your forthcoming year sin. So by this, I want to now make fun of this by saying, is it possible for Allah to forgive all this with just one fasting and all this will be forgiven by Allah? So is it possible that you are not making fun of it, that it is just fun, it's just nothing, it's nothing, that it's going to be possible? Our iqabi, or Allah's punishment, the punishment set down by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, for example, if someone should commit zina and he is married, that such a person will be stoned to death. Then, such a person is not making fun of it. Why will that person be stoned to death, making jest out of Allah's punishment, Allah's judgment? Then any of these kafar, the law is that such a person has become a disbeliever. فَلْيَعَذُ بِاللَّهِ. Such a person has disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by just making fun, making jest of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained. Such an act is an act of disbelief. And the Shaykh says, وَالدَّلِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. And the evidence for this, to show that such a person has disbelieved, is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, قُلْ أَبِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. Say to them, is it Allah, or is it His verses, or is it His messenger that you people are making fun of? لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Don't give any excuses. Don't try to fool yourself or to set yourself out that what I'm doing, I'm just making fun of myself. No, don't give any excuses. قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. You disbelieve. You've all disbelieved after you've having faith in Allah. After having faith in Allah, you've now disbelieved because you make fun of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained, of Allah's punishment, of Allah's reward, or anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down. You make fun of such a thing. Such an act is an act of disbelief. So we should be careful to fall in this. Many people are falling in this, in which they are not aware that they are falling in kufr, making fun of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained. The verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, singing with Allah's verses, all these are acts of disbelief. We should be careful. All these are acts of, we are making fun of Allah's verses. So all these are things that one can easily fall in. We should be careful, and we should call people to order, to attention, that what they are doing is indeed an act of kufr. This verse that Adi Sheikh brought to us, this verse can be found in Surah Al-Tawbah, Quran 9 verse 65. Allah said, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُوضُ وَنَلْعَبَ. And if you should ask these people, they will say to you that we are only talking fun, and we are just having fun with ourselves, and we are joking with ourselves. على أسئلة قل أبي الله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون. Ask them, يا رسول الله, أو Allah's messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, is it Allah and his verses and his messenger that you are making fun of, that you are making jest of? Is it Allah and his messenger that you are making jest of? So this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set it down in a revealed verse to his Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with regards to the battle of Tabuk, Ghazwatu Tabuk. So there were some men that they are claiming that they are Muslims, or they are Muslims and they are mu'min, they are believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So during this battle of Tabuk, some men were sitting down, and as they were sitting down, one of them now stood up and he said, مَا رَأَيْنَا مِثْلَ قَرَائِنَا هَؤُلَىٰ أَوْغَبُ بُطُونًا وَلَا أَكْذَبُ أَلْسِنًا وَلَا أَجْبَنُ عِنْدَ اللِّقَاءِ. That's, I have not seen anyone that loves food more than these people. I have not seen anyone that can tell lies more than these people. I have not seen anyone that is so coward, that is so afraid in the battlefield more than these people. And this man is addressing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. Then in this gathering, there was this Sahaba by the name Auf bin Malik. Auf bin Malik now stood up to rebook what this man said. He said, كَذَبْتَ, you tell lie. وَلَكِنَّكَ مُنَافِقْ, rather, you are hypocrite. لَأُخْبِرَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, I will solely inform Allah's messenger of what you say. I will inform Allah's messenger. Before Auf bin Malik should get to where Rasulullah sallam was, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed verses addressing him. Allah has revealed verses addressing the Prophet sallam on what this man said. Allah revealed this verse that we can see here on our screen. That وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُولَ الْعَبَى. If you should ask these people, they will see we are just having fun, we are just making fun of ourselves. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these verses about this man that said these things now went to Rasulullah and asking him for mercy, for plea. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so eager not to forgive this man, he rode on his horse and he went away. And he did not say anything to this man. The only thing that he was saying was that قُلْ أَبِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. Rasulullah was just repeating these verses to this man. أَبِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. أَبِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. Is it Allah and His Messenger and His verses that you are making fun of? Allah said, لَا تَعْتَدِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Don't give any excuses. Don't try to fool yourself. You've disbelieved after you've having faith. So this verse here, as you can see, بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, that you've disbelieved after you had believed in Allah, shows that the act, that action that this man did by making fun of Allah and His Messenger or His verses, indeed is an act of disbelief. Because Allah said that you've disbelieved after you've had faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one should be careful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them that they are mu'min. These people, they are believers in Allah. But by just making fun of Allah and His verses, Allah tagged them to be a kafir, a disbeliever. They are not hypocrites in the first instance. No, they are mu'min in Allah. Allah addresses them as mu'min, a believer. Had it been these people were hypocrites, were munafiq, Allah will not say قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Allah will say قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِكُمْ, that you've disbelieved after you have become a Muslim. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to alterate the state of a munafiq, Allah will say بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِكُمْ, as he said in Surah Tawbah, verse 74. Addressing the munafiq, the hypocrite, Allah said, يَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ مَا قَالُوا وَلَقَدْ قَالُوا كَلْمَةَ الْكُفْرِ وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِهِمْ. Allah addresses the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, that these people, they've disbelieved after their Islam, after they are claiming to be a Muslim. So the hypocrites, they are claiming to be a Muslim by proclaiming Islam in open, and if they are in private, they will proclaim other religions. So Allah addresses the munafiqeen as Muslim. But these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses them as a mu'min in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they disbelieve in this act that they engage themselves with. So one should be careful in falling in all of this. So there are issues that we'll love to discuss to ourselves in this ayah, in this verse. in these six nullifier of Islam, which is very, very important for us to have to know. Part of it is that one, it is compulsory to respect and magnify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also attributing inferiority to Allah is indeed an act of disbelief, as we've explained. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created us, He knows all what we are doing. So attributing any act of inferiority to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed an act of disbelief. Like the Yahud and the Jew that attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has tied hands, that His hands are tied up. As he said in Surah Al-Ma'idah 1:5 verse 64, that وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ. And the Jews, they say that the hands of Allah are tied up. That is, Allah is stingy. That His hands are tied up. Allah rebuked them. غُلَّتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. Their hands are the ones that are tied up. وَلُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا. And they are caused with what they said. This act, this saying of theirs, leads them to be caused by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if anyone is being caused by Allah, that means such a person has distanced himself away from Allah's mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to understand His verses. Ameen. So this act is an act of disbelief. For one to make Allah inferior. Part of it also that we learn from this sixth nullifier of Islam is that degrading or debasing or doing any act of derogative speech to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is an act of disbelief also. For us to tag the Prophet with a debasing or derogative speech, all these are acts of disbelief. Saying, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to obey and to respect and honor Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even rebuked the Sahaba, some of them that were calling the Prophet by his name, Muhammad, 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 Ya Muhammad, Ya Muhammad. No, Allah wants us to respect him by adding sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that made him a messenger, Allah did not call the Prophet by his name. Allah will say, Ya Rasul, Ya Ayyuhan Nabi. In verses in the Quran, Allah addresses him as Ya Ayyuhan Nabi, Ya Ayyuhan Rasul. At the only places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the Prophet by his name were just four places in the Quran. One in Surah Al Imran, Quran 3 verse 144. One in Surah Al Ahzab, Quran 33 verse 40. One in Surah Muhammad, Quran 47 verse 2. And the last in Surah Al Fath, Quran 48 verse 29. These are the only places Allah addresses the Prophet by his name Muhammad. And Allah addresses him by his name because Allah is telling us information about him. But if Allah is talking to him directly, Allah cannot address him by his name. He will say, Ya Ayyuhan Nabi, Ya Ayyuhan Rasul, or you the Prophet, or you the Messenger. So addressing the Prophet by his name is as if we are debasing him. Just the way one cannot address someone that is older than him in age or in position by his name. One must put some respect in calling such people. One must put some respect. So the same way we have to put respect in calling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying Ya Rasulullah or Muhammad sallallahu by adding at the prayer sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah, Nabiullah, the Prophet. So all these are ways to address Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to respect him. He said in Surah Al-Hujurat, verse 2, that Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tarfa'u aswatakum fawqa sawti an-nabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, for you who believe, don't raise your voice above the voice of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أَنْ تَحْبَطُ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. And you should not, when you call him, you should not speak louder. Let not your voice to be louder than his voice. Because if you should do this, أَنْ تَحْبَطُ أَعْمَالُكُمْ, who knows, maybe by doing that you may spoil your actions. So this act can lead to kufr. By raising your voice above the Prophet's voice, or by calling him in a way whereby you are not supposed to call him with. So this act may lead to kufr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us against this. In other verses in Surah An-Nur, Allah said in Surah An-Nur that لَا تَجْعَلُوا دُعَاءَ الرَّسُولِ بَيْنَكُمْ كَدُعَاءِ بَعْضِكُمْ بَعْضًا. That don't make the calling of the Prophet between yourself like the way you call each other. You call yourself with one's name, Muhammad, Ismail, Idris, Ibrahim, Yahya. But the Prophet should be called with respect. Not Ya Muhammad, Muhammad. Just the way the Jew, the disbelievers in Quraysh called him. They call him by his name Muhammad. But we as Muslims and the companions, they address him with his kunya, Rasulullah, Nabiullah, and with the prayer, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So these are the ways to call Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, we also learn from this that the Quran must be honored and respected as it is the word of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that revealed the Quran to us. So we as humans should respect the Quran, because not respecting the Quran is as if we are not respecting the speech of Allah. And not respecting the speech of Allah is we are not regarding the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah's knowledge is as if we are not regarding Allah's knowledge. And by this, can lead one to kufr. Also, we also learn from this that the scholars should also be respected. Also, the scholars, they are the inheritors of this religion. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this religion to his Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah now passed it. He said that this religion has been passed to the scholars. Al-ulama warathatul anbiya. That the scholars, they are the inheritors of the prophet. What the prophet left, the scholars are the one that inherits them. لَمْ يَرْثُوا دِينَارْ وَلَا دِرْهَمْ. The scholars did not inherit money, dollars, naira, sefa, dinar, riyal. No. But what the scholars inherit? They inherit knowledge. Al-ulama. وَالْغَثُ الْعِلْمِ. They inherit knowledge. So we should respect and regard the scholars. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to us, that he said in Surah, he said that that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise those that believe in you. In Surah Al-Mujadala, verse 11, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise those that believe among you. And also Allah will also raise those that have been given knowledge in ranks. So this is an act of respect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to the scholars. So by debasing the scholars and not regarding them is an act of, can lead one to disbelief also. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to regard the scholars and saying things by tagging them with filthy things. So all this, one should be careful, for these verses are part of what this are saying to us, that we should regard the scholars. So it is very important for us to regard the scholars. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Also, five is that doing away from the gathering where false speeches are being said is compulsory. That is, as we have been told in this verse, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to this man that tagged the prophet and his sahaba with some false statements, Allah addresses them all by saying, "Qul abillahi, is it Allah and his messenger and his verses that you people are making jest of?" This man is not alone in the gathering. He has other people that were with him in the gathering. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this statement that you've all disbelieved to all of them in that gathering, except the person that stood up and rebuked this man, which is Awf bin Malik. So all of them, apart from Awf bin Malik, were all disbelievers. Because they are sitting with this man. While this man is saying this act, this speech of his, these people did not rebuke this man. They are with them there, and they are with him there, and they keep silent while he is saying this. And they did not rebuke this man, neither did they stand up from where they are. They are still with this man, apart from Awf bin Malik. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to leave places where foul speech had been made. If not, we will be with them in the ranks. Allah said in Surah An-Nisa, verse 140, that وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهَزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُولُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا مِثْلُهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَامِعُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْكَافِرِينَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ جَمِيعًا. Allah said, "Verily, we reveal to you in the book that if you should had the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yukfaru biha, these people, they will disbelieve in Allah's verses. And the kuffar, the unbeliever, they will disbelieve in Allah's verses. Wa yustahza'u biha, and they will also make mockery out of it. They will make fun of Allah's verses." Allah now said, "Fala taq'udu ma'ahum." Don't sit with them. While they are making fun of Allah's verses, don't sit with these people. حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ, until if they are to engage in a talk that is different from what they are saying. If not, but if you should stay with them, while they are making fun of Allah's verses, Allah said, Innakum idhan mithluhum. Certainly, in that case, you would be like them. And the punishment we have to give them, you will also share in the punishment, because we are sitting with them while they are making fun of Allah's verses. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tagged all of them in that gathering as kufar. Qad kafartum, Allah is plural. You've all disbelieved after your iman, after having faith in Allah, apart from Auf bin Malik. So it is very vital for us to take this into practice. And also we should take note that as far as istihza is concerned, mockery is of two types. We have al-istihza'u bil qawl, we have mockery of saying this one to make fun of Allah or his verses or his prophet from saying just the way this man Allah rebuked, he did his own through saying. So he said out that the prophet and his sahaba lawful and the likes. So this man said his own mockery and he from saying. Two is that we are al istihza'u bil ishara, mockery out of gesture, for to give sign, like to wink your eye or to make some sign with the hands or with the eyes. So all these are also all these are mockery that if one should engage in can lead one to kufr. And finally, whosoever insult Allah or the prophet or his book or the prophet sunnah as disbelief, whether he's serious or not. So these are the things that can lead one to kufr: insulting Allah or insulting Allah's book, Al-Quran, or insulting the Prophet, or insulting the Prophet's Sunnah. All this will lead one to kufr, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ, is it Allah, his Prophet, his Rasul, that you people are making fun of? So even if you are serious, or even if you are making fun, even if you are playing, as long as what you are doing is mockery, such a person can become a kafir. So we should take note of all these. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to comprehend them all and to apply them in our daily lives. Hada sallallahu wa sallam. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.